Shalom, welcome back to breastlove.org. Insights in the Parsha of the week, Parshat Lech Lecha. We're now beginning to walk. Lech Lecha. Walk to you. Now the year is beginning to take shape. We still haven't seen the shape of the year. With Parshat Lech Lecha, the first of the patriarchs, Avram Avinu, coming into the picture. Wow. We begin now to form who we are, the Jewish nation. Something amazing. An amazing insight in the Parasha is what the Gemara says. The Gemara teaches that anyone who fixes a place to daven, kol hakoveya makom litfilato, anybody who fixes a place for the davening, which means that you're careful to daven always in a fixed shul. You don't daven one day here, one day there, and jump around synagogues, but you try your best to be fixed. And even in the shul itself, you don't jump around. You don't daven one day here, one day there, whatever is feasible. But you fix a place in the shul itself. So the Gemara teaches, anyone who does this, who fixes a place for their davening, the God of Avraham comes to their assistance. So Rabbi Nachman teaches, what does it mean, the God of Avraham? He says, Avraham is the first one who revealed the holiness of Eretz Yisrael. Like it says in the Zohar in this week's Parsha, that Avram Avinu discovered the holiness of Eretz Yisrael. It says, Takal Betikla, he, being a master astrologist, he weighed and measured using concepts that he learned in astrology. So he kept on using them to refine until he discovered the greatness of the Holy Land. Because Hashem didn't tell anything yet to Avram Avinu about the existence of a Holy Land. Yet Avram Avinu on his own began to understand that there must be a place on this earth that mankind can best connect to God at the maximum level. So like the Zohar says, that he used his knowledge of astrology, astronomy, whatever he had, and was able to locate a land which was not governed at all under the influence and energy and power of the stars. That's the greatness of the Holy Land, like the Zohar says. And he was shocked and he was scared to approach it. So the Zohar says that Avram Avinu discovered the Holy Land, but he was scared to enter the Holy Land until he got permission. Once he discovered on his own that there exists a Holy Land, so then Hashem revealed himself, the opening of this parasha, Lech Lecha. Hashem told Avram Avinu, now you're ready. Now that you discover that there's a secret called the Holy Land, now I give you permission, Lech Lecha. I tell you to go. That is where you become the greatness. So Rabbi Nachman teaches by extension that Avram Avinu represents the Holy Land, because he's the one who discovered the Holy Land. So Rabbi Nachman goes on to explain that anyone who fixes their davening, fixes a place for their davening, so he teaches Rabbi Nachman, if you do that, the God of Avraham will assist you, which means what? What does it mean, the God of Avraham will assist you? It means, he teaches, that you draw upon yourself the holiness of the Holy Land. Rabbi Nachman, he teaches that according to Halacha, when we daven, we face the Holy Land. Rabbi Nachman teaches, for a Jew to daven properly, it's not enough to face the Holy Land. You have to actually be in the Holy Land. How in the world can I be in the Holy Land if I'm stuck in New York or LA or Hawaii or Haiti and I'm davening now? How in the world can I be in the Holy Land? So he teaches that if you fix a place for your davening, so the accumulation of the davening in that place and your sincerity in trying your best to daven, this activates the God of Avraham, which means it activates already the holiness of the Holy Land. And the holiness of the Holy Land is already engulfing and encompassing such a person who's trying their best to fix a place for their davening so that they can daven with Kavana. And as a result, they activate the holiness of the Holy Land. And Rabbi Nachman teaches, what is the idea of the Holy Land? The Holy Land represents clear, crystal clear concentration in davening. A sign that a person is in the Holy Land is when they can connect to the davening. And the opposite is also true, that a person has what's called bilbulim, confusions. Rabbi Nachman teaches that the word bilbul is similar etymologically to mabul, the flood. And like the Gemara teaches, and the Zohar holds by this opinion, because there's a dispute in the Gemara, the flood waters in the time of Noah did not reach the Holy Land. Did not. Rabbi Yochanan says in the Gemara that the Mabul did not reach the Holy Land. The Zohar holds that that's the true, correct opinion. So Rabbi Nachman teaches, if there's no floodwaters in the Holy Land, and floodwaters are synonymous with confusions and distractions, so Eretz Yisrael signifies clear-headed davening. So he teaches again, a Jew who works very hard to fix a place for the davening, Elokei Avraham Be'ezro, the God of Avraham comes to his assistance. What's the assistance? To help that person to daven with a clear head. Shabbat Shalom and all the best.